For example, Picasso has been a self-employed artist since 2008. Accounting date is 30th June. His tax liability for the tax year 1718 till 1920 inclusive are as follows. So in 1718, the income tax liability, class 2, class 4, and capital gain tax liabilities are there. Similarly, in 1819 and in 1920. So for 1920, we have to consider 1819. For 1819, we have to consider 1718. Prepare a schedule showing the payment on account and balancing payment that Picasso will have to made or will have to make during the period from 1st July 19 to March 21, assuming that any appropriate claim to reduce her payment on account. Your answer should clearly identify the relevant due date for each payment. So first of all, let me just identify the period that is the requirement of the question that we have to show from 1st July 2019 till 31st March 2021. This is the deadline. So on the basis of that, you can see that if I talk about 18 and 19, so first POA date will be for 18 and 19, that POA will be 31st January 2019. The second POA will be 31st July 2019. And the balancing payment will be 31st January 2020. And for 1920, the first POA will be 31st January 2020. The second POA is 31st July 2020, and the balancing payment for that is 31st January 2021. Now let's match the period. That the question says that identify the payment between these two. So on the basis of that, you can see that the relevant date that we have to meet, you can identify from this data. So on the basis of we can identify that this falls in the above date. Similarly, this one. Similarly, all these values, and this is as well. So we have and as far as the 2021 is concerned, the POA of 2021, the first POA of 2021 also falls in this date, that is 31st January 2021. And second POA is 31st July 2021. So it's not relevant. And this one is also relevant. Now, according to that, now we'll identify POA of 1819, balancing payment of 1819, and then 1920, and then 2021. So let's just work out for 18 and 19, and then 1920 and onwards. So let's just focus on the question that for 18 and 19, we'll consider the 17 and 18 data. So for 17 and 18 data, let's identify the POA. So for 17 and 18, we can make it like that. We are identifying POA of for 18 and 19. And for this, we have taken the data of 17, 18. And 17 and 18 data says that income tax liability in class 4, 3240, 1240. So it's 3240 plus 1240. And income tax liability is 4480. And this is also the relevant amount, as there is no payee is there. So divided by 2, and our POA is 2240. POA. So in this way, we can say that this POA is for 31st July 2019. And now for 18 and 19, let's identify the balancing payment. For balancing payment, I have to consider the actual liability of 18 and 19, all. So we have income tax, 4,100. We have class 4 NIC. We have class 2 NIC. And we have CGT. So 1480, 153, and 4880. So this is the actual liability, 10613. There is no payee. So deduct the POA, the two POA. First one is 2240, second one is 2240. It's 4480. 2240 into 2. So it's 4480. Deduct this from this. So we have 6133, the balancing payment. And this balancing payment date is 31st January 2020. So in this way, the POA of 1819 and balancing payment of 1890. Now 1920, we have to calculate income tax liability for 19 and 20. So let's see that as far as the 1920 liability is concerned, if I compare it with 18 and 19, you can see that the liability of 1920 is less than the liability of 1819. That means the concept of reduced POA is applicable here. And now for 1920, instead of taking the previous year liability, consider the 1920 figure for POA. So for 1920, I will consider the 1920 figure for POA. So in this way, for reduced liability, so income tax of 1920 and class 4 NIC. So it's 2730, 990. So total liability is 3720. Now 2 POA, so divided by 2 or make it 50%. So we have first POA of 1860 and second POA of 1860. This is 31st January 2020. This is second one is 31st July 2020. So in this way, so these are the two POA. And now the balancing figure. So the balancing figure for 1920, now consider all liabilities. Again, let's calculate the balancing payment. So income tax and class 4. Income tax and class 4. The above value, that is 3720. Add class 2 NIC, and that is 156. CGT is 0. So we have 3876 is the liability minus POA already paid, 2 POA, 1860 into 2, that is 36,3720. And the balancing figure is 156. So this is the balancing payment, and this balancing payment is required for 1920. So this is the balancing payment, and the date is 31st January 2021. Now one payment is left, that for 2020 and 2021, as actual data is not there, so I'll use the previous year 1920. For POA. So for 1920, income tax and class 4. So income tax is 2730. Class 4 is 990 and it's 3720, and minus, there is no pay, so there is no pay, so this is the relevant amount divided by 2 or 50% of that, so 1860. This is POA for 2020 and 2021. So this POA is based on the date that I have identified, 31st January 2021. So in this way, I have covered the POA of 1819, POA of 1920, balancing payment, as well as POA of 2020.